And it's not who can say it had come to pass unless the Lord himself has declared it. The Bible says, I saw one brother wearing a nice t-shirt here. There is no weapon. There is no weapon. Whether created with the Arabs or with the terrorists, there is no weapon. No missile, no nuclear, no atomic, no nothing that is formed against me that will prosper.
Amen.
What God is out to hand out to me tonight before the end of the service, nobody's going to stop it. It's not going to somebody else. Oh, that package is addressed to me. That is my package. That is my stuff. That is kind to me. I am an heir. I am an heir tonight. I am an heir to God's promises. Now, this is what happened in the life of Joseph. The Bible says the devil's kinder product, a program, all a lie. They took that jacket and they dipped it in blood and they presented evidence to his father. You see that? It was evidence that Joseph is dead. And Jacob lamented for somebody who was not dead. Jacob cried. He moaned. For somebody who was alive. Let me tell you something. Your dream is alive tonight. The dream of this ministry is alive. We don't care what the devil is saying. We are alive and well. We are standing here against evidence. The devil says, this is what is happening. God says, come on, my son. There is a way out of this. There is a way out of this. And you know the God I serve is a wonderful God. Do you know in the story of Joseph that God wanted him to be a governor? He wanted him to be a president. But you know, God does not direct Joseph to some little guys below there.
Come on.
Are you getting it?
Yes.
Are you hearing it?
Yes.
Now, what God does to our lives, what God does to our dreams, what God does to our promises will always guide us to where our dream is going to be fulfilled.
Yes.
Come on.
There's a way it's not going to be fulfilled. No matter how low we feel, no matter how down we feel, but God's way of giving us and handing us a promise is always towards where our dream is directed.
Amen.
Amen.
That's
a phrase.
Devil, you're a liar. Oh, Satan, you're a liar tonight. Oh, I hear you lying. I hear you saying you've been here for many years. It's not happened yet. Tell him it's a lie.
It's a lie.
It's a lie.
It's a lie.
It's a lie tonight. I know him whom I have believed. And he's able. He's able to keep me from falling. He's able to bring me to that place where I'm going to receive my dream.
Amen.
You know, when a dream dies, you're dead. We should never allow our dreams to die. We should never allow our hopes to die. We should never allow the promise of God in our lives to die.
Thank you, my brother.
I'm telling you here, when Jacob looked at that, you know, the devil is such a liar. I mean, have you ever had a lion eat up somebody and the jacket remains behind? I mean, if a bear attacks you, Brother Gatron, can a bear remove your jacket then eat you up? What an exhibit of a liar. What Jacob should have asked his son was, how come the jacket is intact?
Right.
Yet my son is dead.
Amen.
We need to ask the devil tonight, how come you say I can make it, but Jesus is alive tonight?
Amen.
How come you say I cannot be healed when Jesus is the healer?
Yes.
How you say, I can't get a job when he is a giver? How come you say, I cannot be delivered when he is my deliverer? The devil is a liar tonight. We are standing against evidence. I'm here to declare there is another court in heaven. It's called the High Court.
All right.
The High Court in heaven is sitting tonight. It's declaring. He lied to you, brother. He lied to you, my sister. Let keep that dream alive.
Keep it.
Don't let it.
When Jacob was out there mourning, looking at that jacket of his son, Joseph was going up the ladder.
Yes, he was.
He was climbing up the ladder.
Hey.
He was getting closer and closer. You know, what happened is those men that sold him, they did not sell him to some cheap backyard dealer. Where was he sold to? Where he was going?
Yes.
Into Potiphar's house.
Yes.
See what God does?
Yes.
You are servant.
Yes.
You're going to be a politician. So yes. God trained him. He put him in a politician's house.
Yes. Right.
The mistake that the devil has done is to bring you here tonight. He should never have allowed you to come here.
All right.
He made a mistake. The devil made a mistake by allowing you to be here tonight. You should have been in a tavern. You should have been in a nightclub. You should have been in the street. You should have been in somewhere where your life is wasted tonight. But he made a mistake. He sold Joseph to Potiphar's house.
Yes.
You know what the scripture says in the book of Galatians, the 4th chapter? It says, an heir, as long as he's a child. As long as he's a child. He sits under governors and tutors. And here is Joseph in the house of Potiphar. The prince of Pharaoh, the highest rank in the land of Egypt.
Right.
The dream is not dead, my brother.
No.
No. I may not have been healed yesterday. I may not be healed this afternoon.
Yes.
But the dream is not dead.
Not dead.
He's such a liar.
Glory.
I know Brother Bill loves the word.
Yes.
In Swahili it says Kanyanga.
Yes.
He is a liar.
He's a liar.
You put down your foot on him. The scripture in the book of 2 John, I believe it is, it says, and God is going to put the devil under your feet shortly. You know that scripture like that? Shortly. Before it's all over.
Yes.
I mean, you feel so booked down. You feel so lost. You feel so without grace and power.
Yes.
You feel so weak. You feel you can't go on.
Yes.
But I'm here to tell you, he should not have allowed you to listen this message tonight.
Yes.
He made a mistake to allow you to hear my voice.
Amen.
My God.
My God.
Oh. We are on the move, my brother.
Oh, yeah.
We are on the move, my sisters.
Yes.
We are going on.
Yes.
In the you know, it's a choo-choo train.
Yeah.
It's going choo, choo, choo. Sometimes you think it's never going to go. It goes choo,
choo, choo, choo.
Soon you're going to hear it. It's going, my brother. It's coming. I didn't hear it.
My God.
You're planning on divorce. It's too late. You should have divorced before you came.